Hey guys, welcome back to part 4 of the series. So last time where we left, we were able to get a wall inside a game window. So in this tutorial, our goal is to make our player. So just let's start making our player. So our player is a circle, right? Now that's why we need to define the radius of our circle. N stands for the number of blocks which it has to dodge. So in our case, n is equal to 5, so our player will be would be designed in such a way that it will dodge five blocks. Then window height and window width, so you already know. So let's just make us okay. Now before so these are the basic attributes of a player. Now we need to define the position of our player. So before we go in that so I have made this sketch so to better understand what we are going to do. So initially what we want our player to be in the middle of the screen at the bottom of our window. So basically right at the somewhere like around here, right in the middle of the screen. Plus what more we want is so in the middle of the screen. And now our player can exist in 5 discrete locations, right? So why we are doing why we are choosing discrete, so I'll explain it when we will start making our reinforcement learning agent. I'll explain it at that time. So for now let's make it only for 5 discrete locations. So this discrete locations would be the middle of the block which are dropping from the top to bottom. So say if I'm at the middle of this in your first block, so in order to get in the middle of us in the middle of an adjacent block, I need to the player step should be equal to the width of the block, right? So this is width by 2, width by 2. If we sum them over, we'll get our widths. Okay, so that's what we are going to do. So let's just define first. Let's first define the position. So self.x and self.y. Okay, so self.x. As I told you, we want our player to be in the middle of this width, right? So we can simply do window width divided by 2. And for the y position, so this line is self height of our window, so we want about 10 or 20 pixels above that. So we will use window height minus 20. So we have defined our self.x and self.y. Now the position of our player. Now what we can define more is like now we need to define the speed or the step, self.step. So how many steps it can take, how many pixel steps it can take in each time. So it should be equal to the width of our window. Now if you remember from the previous tutorial, the width of our each block is window width divided by n. So we can simply write here window width divided by n, right? And one more condition we can put is like, okay, we will put it later. So now let's just quickly write a function to draw a function. So draw player self. And we will use our pygame module, inside which there is a function named draw, inside which there is a function named circle. Now this circle takes 4 parameters, first being the display object itself, second being the color, third being the position, and fifth being the radius or the size. So we have defined our display object. So this function would require a display object, so we will pass it from our game class this particular display object. So game disk. Okay, so this function expects a game display object. Then let color, let's keep it blue. So 0, 0, 255 RGB, and the position is we have just defined it self.x, self.y, and radius we can put it as self.radius. Okay, so this function will draw our player. So now let's just have a look at our player. So let's define a object of our player. So let self.player is equal to player. We need to pass the parameters, so window width, window height, n is equal to 5, so let's just pass 5, and radius, though let's keep it 10. Okay, so let's just draw a player after the blocks are being drawn, or we put the blocks in self.player.drawPlayer, and this function expects a parameter, so self.gameDisplay. So let's just close this one and run again. So we have we got our player, but we can't move it. So we will use our event loop for a particular manipulation of position of our player. So let's just define two functions here quickly for moving left. Move left self. So for moving left, what we want is remember I told you in the previous tutorial that in computer graphics the origin is at top left corner. So if you move from left to right, the x value will increase. So if you want to move to left, so we have to decrease our x value. So this particular x value, what we'll do is we will decrease it by self.x is equal to minus equal to self.step. Okay, so whatever the value of self.step is, which is actually eventually the width of our window, width of our block. So eventually that value will decrease from the x and it will move in the circle. The player will move left. Okay, so we need one more condition, but we'll put it later. Okay, so def move right self. So in order to move right, we will add our step, so equal to self.step. Okay, so we have defined our functions in self.move left and move right in our player class. Now we want to check when we want our player to be moved. So we have to check our event. So if event dot type is equal to pygame dot key down. So now if we press any button, so the pygame event module will capture that event and store it in the event object. And we can check that if event dot type is equal to pygame dot key down. So what we want is we want to check which button has been pressed. So if event dot key is equal to pygame dot k underscore left. So this will be the left arrow key. So we want to do something. We want to move right. Move right. If event dot key is equal to pygame dot k underscore right. So move left. And then we want to move. Right. So now if I define the function here only, so what will happen, it will keep on moving left. If I define my if I call the move right function, like if I write here self dot player dot move right, and if I run it, so once I press the right button, it will keep on moving right. So we don't want that, right? So I want a discrete subset. If I press right click right arrow button once, so it should move take one step right and stop there only. So we will define a two boolean variables here. So like left is equal to right is equal to false. So in case if the left key button has been pressed, so we will put left equal to true, or else if the right button has been pressed, so we will put right equal to true. Okay, now after the event loop, we want to check is there any change in the values of left or right. Left is unsigned. Why? Okay, we'll see what happened. So we will put if left is true. So what we want to move up here. So self dot player dot move left. Okay, and if and yeah, after that, after moving the player, we want to reset our left value. So left will equal to false, will become false, else if right, so self dot player dot move right. Okay, and after that moving, we want to reset our right key. So why I'm getting this warning? Okay, so I don't know. So left and so let's check out let's say what happens now. So let's run it. So yeah, if I press left right, so we are able to get in some discrete locations. Now if I keep on pressing left, so our player will eventually move outside the window. So we want to limit our player's movement to this point and this point. Okay, so what we can do is here, after when we are defining a move left function, so we can write here if self dot x is less than self dot step. Step is basically the width of a window. If it gets less than step dot window, half of the width of the window. So let me comment this. So this is the width of a window, right? This is the width of the block. So half of the width of the block would come somewhere here. So we want to we want our player to be eventually at this position. So this is what we are going to do. So if step dot x is equal to step dot 2. So what we want, we want to define a player at self dot step divided by 2. Similarly for right, if we move right, so if self dot x is greater than window height minus self dot step divided by 2. So half the window, half the size of the width of the block minus the window width, sorry, not height, width. So this is the window, let's say this is the window, so window width will width value is here, so half the width of the block, so we'll land up somewhere here, and where the eventually the block is this, so we want a player to restrict to here only. So self dot x equal to, okay, so now if we run it again and we get some error. Intention error. So window width is not defined. Oh yeah, window width spelling. Oops. Okay. Oh, it should be self dot window width, sorry. So if I move my player right, so it will stop. I'm pressing the right key button, but it is stuck there. If I move left, so it is stuck there. So we have restricted our player movement, and we are able to move it to discrete locations. Now in the next tutorial, we'll start code for the interactions between the player and the blocks. Like if it touches the block, so our player should die, the game should collapse, or if the player is crossing this particular save block, so we want a score to be displayed, and the score should increase. Also the speed of the block should increase after every 5 points. Thank you.